I'm down for another match.
Wait, what? Is it really 2 a.m.?
No way!
Guilty as charged. And while yes, the game is partially to blame here, it's also the fault of the screen itself and the blue light it emits. If you're a fan of late night screen time, never fear. We've got ways to keep your peepers protected. This is DIY in 5. Hey everyone, welcome to DIY in 5, the show where we take tech and make it simple enough that you can do it yourself. Today we're talking blue light blocking, what it is and how to protect your eyes from blue light so that you can game and doom scroll in peace, if that's even possible. If you find the tips in today's video useful, please go ahead and like this video, subscribe to this channel, and hit that bell so that you don't miss out on any future tech tips. Blue light is a type of light emitted by screens that stimulates your brain. It does so in such a way that can cause eye strain, headaches, and your brain can even be fooled into thinking that it's daytime, which can be a problem if you like to work late at night or look at your phone before you fall asleep. Now, researchers are constantly releasing new studies on the potential harm of blue light, and while there have been some studies that suggest this isn't truly to blame for your insomnia as much as people think, regardless, these tips and tricks are so simple that it's worth a go if you're a late night browser or often experience headaches or eye strain after a long period of computer or phone use. The first hack to think about isn't even a tech solution. The 20/20/20 rule suggests that anyone using a device for an extended period should look away from the screen every 20 minutes, at least 20 feet away, for at least 20 seconds. I will never remember to do that personally, but it is a healthy habit to get into if you can manage it. Let's start with mobile solutions, since most of us are guilty of late night or simply too much phone use. If you're an iPhone user, the night shift feature allows you to filter out blue light and adjust the warmth of the colors on your display. It will automatically do this at sunset and return your screen to its normal display settings in the morning. To enable night shift, simply open Control Center, press Brightness Control, and tap the symbol that looks like a sun. Or if you want to go through Settings, go to Settings, Display and Brightness, and toggle Night Shift. In Settings, you also have the option to set specific schedules if you don't want sunset and sunrise to be the start point and end time, or manually turn it on and off as it suits you. If you do not see the sunset to sunrise option in your settings, you may need to turn on the setting time zone option in your location and system services. For Android users, this will differ slightly depending which manufacturer your phone is from. For Samsung phones, this feature is called Blue Light Filter, and you can access it from your quick settings. For Pixels, this feature is called Nightlight and is available in your display settings. Both features allow you to adjust the intensity level and start-stop times. For other Android options, check your display settings and see if your phone has this type of feature, albeit under a different name. If your phone does not have this feature built in, there are third-party apps like Blue Light Filter, S Filter, and Twilight Blue Light Filter that will get the job done just fine. For the gamers out there or workaholics using full-screen applications, sometimes full-screen applications will automatically override any nightlight settings that you have enabled. If this is you, know that some monitors will now come with built-in blue light filtering. And if none of these solutions work for you, another option is blue light filtering glasses. There are varying levels of filtering, with stronger options traditionally having more of a yellow tint than others, and they come in all shapes, sizes, and even prescriptions too. I have blue light filtering in my everyday glasses, prescription gunner clearer lensed glasses for longer computer sessions while streaming, and some really intense blockers if I'm not streaming and playing super late into the evening. Between glasses, hardware solutions, and software solutions, and the good old 20/20/20 rule, there are many different ways to protect your eyes from blue light. What's your preferred solution? Let us know in the comments. All right, take care everyone, and thank you for watching DIY in 5.